guys, thank you so much for joining me today for another video. This is actually going to be the first video of a new series I'm hoping to start. I think tentatively I'm going to be calling this series Behind the Brands. I realized that while I wear a lot of Lolita for my channel here and just on a daily basis when I go out with my friends and stuff like that, I really don't know very much about the brands themselves. Information like how they started, who founded them, when they were founded, just like the history of Lolita brands. And so I just started looking into more about the behind the scenes of these brands and their histories, and I thought I would share the information I found with you guys. I hope that at least some of you out there will find this a little bit interesting. If you'd like to see me continue this series, definitely let me know down below. I really want to make content you guys enjoy. So today I am wearing my Baby Doll JSK from Baby the Star Shine Bright because that is the brand that I will be starting with for this series. So if you would like to know a little bit more about how the brand Baby the Star Shine Bright got started and a little bit more about its history, feel free to keep watching the rest of the video. And if you'd like to see more kawaii and Lolita fashion content, I post videos for you guys every Monday and Thursday, so feel free to hit that subscribe button down below if you'd like to stick around for that. And if you do like this video while you're watching, also feel free to hit that thumbs up button down below. It really helps me out. Well guys, grab your tea and your macarons and let's have a little Lolita history lesson. Baby was founded as a brand in 1988 by Akinori Isobe and his wife Fumio. Now, the name Baby the Star Shine Bright actually comes from an English pop band called Everything But the Girl. One of their albums is named Baby the Star Shine Bright. Now, prior to founding Baby the Star Shine Bright, Isobe and his wife both worked for another designer. This designer was called Atsuki Onishi, and Isobe actually credits him as the pioneer for today's Lolita fashion in Japan, and he was greatly inspired by him for Baby the Star Shine Bright's designs. So Isobe and his wife worked for Atsuki Onishi in the mid-80s, and then he decided he wanted to do something on his own. He knew that he really wanted a career in designing and making clothes, he just wasn't quite sure exactly what he wanted to design. So after leaving Atsuki Onishi and before Baby the Star Shine Bright was created, he actually had several different design companies before Baby was founded. So when Baby was founded in 1988, he actually didn't even design Lolita clothing for the first entire year that Baby existed. And he states because he wasn't truly designing anything he liked, the brand did not do well at first. However, one of the clients that he worked with dealt with making Lolita fashion, and he realized that that is what he really wanted to do, and he would pursue Lolita fashion for himself. So Isobe finally made the decision to get into Lolita fashion, and so he did more of the silhouette design work, while his wife focused more on fabric sourcing and print designs. And they clearly worked well as a team because they were able to open their flagship store in 1999. The original Baby the Star Shine Bright shop was located in Daikanyama, which is in the Shibuya area of Tokyo. However, it was relocated to the Omotesando area in 2012. Now, along with Baby the Star Shine Bright, they did actually found a sister brand called Alice and the Pirates in 2004. However, I would like to do another video separately for Alice and the Pirates, so I'll just give you that little tidbit for now. They found great success in the Japanese market with their Lolita designs, and they were actually able to expand into the European market with a location in Paris in 2007. However, unfortunately, that location did close in 2017. Not long after they opened their location in Paris in 2007, they moved into the Western US market by opening a location in San Francisco in 2009. Thankfully, this location is still going strong. I've gotten several pieces from that location myself. It's awesome. If you haven't been, definitely go check it out. After these initial physical store locations opened up, they did start an online shop in 2013 as well. And then finally, they opened a secondary location in the US in New York in 2014. However, that location did also unfortunately close in 2018. So while there are still several locations in Japan, of course, there is only one located in the US in San Francisco. Now, of all of these locations that they've had, their most popular location by far was the original Daikanyama location. And this was greatly due to the fact that this location was referenced in the cult classic film for Lolitas, Kamikaze Girls. Now, while they didn't actually film in the original Daikanyama shop because it is very small, the store itself was referenced in the movie and they built a set to mimic the Baby the Starshine Bright shop. Now, if you haven't heard of Kamikaze Girls, like I said, it is a classic film that all Alitas should watch, in my opinion. The story focuses on Momoko and Ichigo. Momoko is a Lolita who lives in the rural countryside of Japan, who loves wearing Lolita and dreams of living in the city so that she can be where the fashion she loves is designed. And Ichigo is in a girl biker gang. It's a really great and hilarious movie about how they somehow forge a relationship and a friendship together, and Baby the Star Shine Bright makes all of the Lolita clothes that Momoko wears in the movie. I don't want to spoil the rest of the plot or anything too detailed, but they did have an actor come in and actually play Isobe himself for the movie. Now, the actual mannerisms and physical appearance of this Isobe in Kamikaze Girls is just a caricature that was written by the author of the original Kamikaze Girls book. And Isobe actually had a bit of a funny quote about his reaction to seeing himself played in the movie. He made comments about how his characterization in the movie is purely imagination, as he himself in real life is just a plain otaku old man. Now, coming up to modern times, Isobe and his wife are still the co-CEOs of the company. However, they've brought in quite a few more designers. They have different teams of designers that work on Baby the Star Shine Bright and Alice and the Pirates separately. Now, to my knowledge of what I could find, there are currently three designers for Baby the Star Shine Bright. Their current head designer is Uehara Kumiko. Now, the earliest confirmed involvement I could find between her and Baby was back in 2011. She went to fashion school at Bunka College in Tokyo, and she knew from a very young age that she wanted to be a fashion designer. She learned about Lolita fashion while in college, and as soon as she graduated, she immediately went to apply to work at Baby. However, at the time she applied, the company was still very small, and Isobe and his wife weren't looking to take on any designers at the time, so she was actually initially turned down completely. However, this did not dampen her spirits or her inspirations. She actually went on to start her own brand, and while her clothing was being featured in a magazine, Isobe saw it himself and actually called her back and offered her a job. So she is now the head designer for Baby the Star Shine Bright. She makes all of the main pieces that have that really classic baby look to them, the solid cotton with the torch and lace designs. She is also responsible for all shoes, bags, and parasols. I have watched a few interviews with her on YouTube, and she looks so cute and sweet, and you can tell she really loves her job and the designs that she gets to do for Baby the Star Shine Bright. Now, as far as the other two designers, there's not nearly as much information about them out there, but their names are Kano Masumi and Tachibana Saki. Masumi states that she went to the Bunka Fashion College and started working for Baby right after she graduated, and she talks a little bit about how she prefers and is more talented at designing the classical and hime or princess designs that Baby puts out. And as far as Saki goes, she actually worked as an assistant for Baby while she was still in college and was elevated to designer after she graduated. But it sounds like she really just assists everyone across the board and works as more of a co-designer to whoever needs help. I have seen that all three designers do all together and separately travel around the world to conventions to represent Baby the Star Shine Bright and help host any fashion shows that they put on. And now that I've learned about them a little bit, I can't wait for conventions to start safely being a thing again. I hope they come over to the US and I can make it to some of the conventions that they appear at. Today, Baby is considered one of, if not the, top Lolita brand names, and I really don't see that changing anytime soon. And while some of their international stores have closed, there's really no lack of interest in their designs, especially on the online market. Considering for the US, we have one single location all the way in California, our only sources really are online. So if you're in the US, your options from buying from Baby the Star Shine Bright are ordering from the San Francisco website. You can also purchase directly from the Japanese Baby the Star Shine Bright website and they will ship it to you, or you could try the secondhand markets on Lace Market or someplace like Wonderwelt. And if you haven't yet purchased an item for yourself from Baby the Star Shine Bright, I really can't recommend them enough. I love their quality and their designs, and I hope this little bit of information might spark your interest. And to wrap up all this information, I would like to end with a quote directly from Isobe himself about the message he wants his brand to convey. He states, "It is you, not others, who decide to convey your own notion of beauty in your way of dressing." Or as Momoko's grandma says in Kamikaze Girls, "Go your own path." I think that is such a beautiful sentiment, and if I didn't already love Baby the Star Shine Bright enough, I definitely have a lot more respect and love for it now that I know a little bit more about its history. From what I read about everyone that's been involved with the brand from its founding to today's point, I really do support their work, and they seem like very genuine, good-hearted people that love what they do and want to share their passion for this fashion with the world. I'm happy to be able to share all this information with you guys. I hope you did enjoy it. I would really like to make more in this series, so if you did also enjoy this video, please let me know down below so I can know whether or not to keep making this series. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up here, guys. Thank you so much for spending some time with me today on my channel. I really appreciate you being here, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!